In today's video, we will be looking at the potential roster for the 2022 Team USA Olympic hockey team. This is very exciting for me personally, as an American and a former hockey player myself, just because of the progression of hockey in the United States over the past several years. The Americans are closing the gap each and every year on the Canadians in terms of hockey talent, and it is evident in the players USA will be able to bring to the Olympics. So without further ado, here are my predictions for what the 2022 Team USA Olympic roster may look like. Starting it off with the first line at center, I have from North Chelmsford, Massachusetts, Jack Eichel, who will be 25. At left wing, from Salem, New Jersey, I have Johnny Gaudreau, who will be 28. And at right wing, from Buffalo, New York, Patrick Kane, who will be 33. This line would be fantastic in my opinion, with two elite players in Kane and Gaudreau, alongside Jack Eichel, who can do it all. I feel that they would rival any other top line in this Olympic Games. For the second line, I have equally as dangerous at center, from San Ramon, California, Austin Matthews, who will be 24. At left wing, from Shelby Township, Michigan, Kyle Connor, who will be 25. And at right wing, from Plymouth, Minnesota, Blake Wheeler, who will be 35. This line would provide just as much as the first line, I think, and would have blazing speed and goal-scoring ability with Connor, dynamic play, defensive responsibility, and even more goal scoring ability with Matthews, and then a guy in Blake Wheeler that's one of the best passers in the league and can also play a hard, fearless game as well. For the third line, at center, I would put, from Waterford, Michigan, Dylan Larkin, who will be 25. At left wing, from Omaha, Nebraska, Jake Guentzel, who will be 27. And at right wing, from Scottsdale, Arizona, Matthew Tkachuk, who will be 24. This line would provide a different element to the team. It'd still be very tough to play against, with Tkachuk, an absolute pest, who also has top-tier talent, Larkin, who has blazing speed and skill, but can also protect the puck and play tough, and Guentzel, who is an incredibly smart hockey player with finishing ability and no problem going to the dirty areas to win puck battles. And on the fourth line, at center, I would have, from Plover, Wisconsin, Joe Pavelski, who will be 37. At left wing, from East Palestine, Ohio, JT Miller, who will be 28. And at right wing, from Burnsville, Minnesota, Brock Besser, who will be 24. I chose to keep Pavelski on the roster because he can really do it all as a hockey player and would also be a potential power play weapon at the front of the net, tipping pucks and causing havoc. And then, Besser and Miller, who are two guys that obviously play together in Vancouver and are big-time point producers, who can also potentially play different roles if they needed to. For the fifth line of extra forwards to bring, at center, I'd bring, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Vincent Trocheck, who will be 28, at left wing, from New Canaan, Connecticut, Max Pacioretty, who will be 33. And at right wing, from Dorchester, Massachusetts, Kevin Hayes, who will be 29. This is obviously a very stacked group of forwards, maybe not quite as deep as Team Canada, but it is getting very close. And now moving on to the defense corps. The Americans have some top-notch guys who can represent their country. On the top unit, I would have, from Denver, Colorado, Jacob Slavin, who will be 27, with John Carlson from Natick, Massachusetts, who will be 32. In Slavin, you obviously have arguably the best defensively responsible shutdown guy in the NHL. And in Carlson, you have a brilliant puck mover who's also dynamite offensively. For the second pair, I would have, from Gross Point, Michigan, Zach Werenski, who will be 24, alongside teammate Seth Jones from Arlington, Texas, who will be 27. These are two guys who have played together for a few years now and have been some of the best D-men in the league. And even though neither are having the best start to this season, I wouldn't let a rough stretch keep them from the games because the upside is phenomenal. On the third pairing, I would have from Orlando, Florida, Quinn Hughes, who will be 22, with Charlie McAvoy from Long Beach, New York, who will be 24. Hughes is one of the most dynamic players in the league already in his second NHL season, and McAvoy is one of the more underappreciated guys in the league. And this year, he will continue to prove his immense value to his Boston Bruins team. I think these guys would make an amazing pair. And now for the extra defenseman they might bring, I have from Jericho, New York, Adam Fox, who will be 23, and Jeff Petrie from Ann Arbor, Michigan, who will be 34. Petrie could possibly even make the main roster if he continues to play better and better, and he's a guy that is aging like fine wine as a veteran defender. Now, moving on to the goaltenders, another very strong spot for the Americans. The starter, in my opinion, would have to be from Commerce, Michigan, Connor Hellebuck, who will be 28. Hellebuck obviously won the Vezina Trophy for best goalie in the league last season, and I can only imagine how tough he would be playing behind that stacked American defense corps. And for the backup, I think this is another fairly obvious selection. From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, John Gibson, who will be 28 as well. Gibson has also been one of the best goalies in the league for many years now, but the last few seasons he's gone fairly unnoticed due to the fact that he's been playing for the Anaheim Ducks, who haven't been a contender for quite a few years now. He was an absolute beast when he played in the World Juniors for the US in 2013, and I think he could definitely do it again if he needed to. The third goalie that I would bring would be from Denver, Colorado, Ben Bishop, who will be 35. If Bishop can get back to being fully healthy, he's another of the very best goalies in the NHL and would be a viable third option for the US. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know down in the comments if I missed anyone you would bring. And please remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video.